Okay, so I think in addition to the 6Q stuff, we'll go through a warm-up so that Jerry can get that on video, and we can have that available for beginners in the future, you know, to explain some of the things that are going on. Okay? So it will just keep a avenue for the film. Everything down to your center. Your dominant hand is underneath, and gather the energy from head to toe at your center. Relax your shoulders. And then let it dissipate and stop. Toes. Press your heel down and there, so stretch your lower calf. Thank you. So when you're doing this, not just go up and down, rotate them around. It's one of the common injuries, not so much for us, but it's out there, rotator cuff injury. So to rotate your shoulders forward at a maximum and back. Up towards your ears and then drop. Put everything down. Big circles. And a drain. And crisscross. Angle.
So rest your head right on the mat, feel yourself sink into the mat, then rock back and forth so you relax your head and stretch your neck, and let that stop, then rock forward to stretch the back, and settle again.
Stretch one arm
through and roll up and back on your shoulder again to open up the shoulder girth. You turn your one that's stretched through that hand, you can turn it over, rotate it back and forth to go along with your shoulder movement. And then stretch, pull back on the movement. And switch. Roll on your shoulder. And then stretch it out a little bit. Okay, back to the middle. Forehead down, let your head sink again.
Side your lower back, upper hip, and then hold it to one side, relax, middle, hold to one side, relax, middle, and throw your feet in again. percussions to bring to life. Stretch the toes back so you can stretch the metatarsals. And rotate the ankle. Then I use my thumbs to do some reflexology up your instep, you know. It's coordinating with the spine. So you just work along there. If you find a tender spot, just hang there for a moment. Just settle with it. And it'll probably, you know, link up to lower back, most likely. Walk them along, press me in the feel yourself sink into the mat, knees are up. Let your knees rock back and forth, and it draws your hips along with it. And one hip will come up, and the other hip will come up. And you finally stretch it through, so you're pressing through on the front of your hip. So you're stretching the front of your hip. Okay, and then come back with swing a couple times, and push on the other side. Okay, it comes back, let it relax. Now rock from your heels up and back. So you rock on your heels, so you push your spine up and down along the mat, right up through your head. You feel your head moving with the rocking. And just relax your spine, relax your hips, relax your shoulders, relax your neck. And let that come to a stop. And one foot over the other unit and draw that knee down. And nice, comfortable, easy, relaxed stretch. And switch. Up, the other knee is stretched out straight along the mat. Whichever knee is up, use the opposite hand, reach over, take that knee and draw it down. Just in your hips, hook your spine. Breathe and relax. Are actually going to be part of 6Q, but they're also part of our warm-up. So hands start comfortable on your knees. One leg is tucked, the other knee is up. When you roll back, you switch them, and you give a little light kick. Don't let your hands come away. I'll just show it. this. You can feel free to let your hands move around your knees, because once this knee is down, this hand could come off and push up if I wanted to. And as a reminder for everyone with hakama sabaki, or hakama movement, when this leg goes back, with my fingers, I'll give a little tap to the hakama, catch it underneath. Time to mention too that maybe Paul can back me up on this. Where's Paul? Paul would know. There's no just gi in Japanese. It's either keiko gi or do gi. But in the West, we changed it to just shorten it to just gi. So just to give everybody a education. Do gi would be uniform for practicing the way. Keiko gi is practice uniform. Okay? Oh, okay. Okay, so next, wrist stretches. And you might, Jerry, you might want to zoom in on these, okay? First one, ikkyo, okay? On the back of your hand, okay? This point of your wrist comes up towards your chin. Press your elbows in for more stretch. Important to do these stretches because it'll, more likely prevent any wrist, injuries. Okay, so do it so that you actually stretch. If you're not feeling anything, then you want to press it a little bit. Not so much that you actually injure yourself, but the stretch out. Okay, so that's ikkyo. Next one, nikkyo. Okay, thumb down. Okay, thumb up. The trick is to confuse Roman. Okay, thumb up and thumb down. Okay. Then come in, my little finger is going to get my own thumb, my thumb goes over the top, to the edge, relax your shoulders and elbows, draw that edge in towards your nose. Okay. Switch. And don't move towards it. If you got a short nose, bring it to your nose. Don't go. If you got a big nose, you got to back up. Okay, next one. Sankyo. Down out. Reach over the top. And grab this edge of your hand. Little fingers at the base of your own little finger. Press through and extend through your thumb. Having fun. Yep. Twisting and stretching. And as you do this, you can move it off toward your side. Okay. So now slide down to your fingertips. Okay. Continue that stretch. Push your elbow up and push your fingertips towards your own armpit. Edge of the hand, little finger in the base of your little finger. Extend through your thumb and draw over the top, twist and stretch. Okay, and gradually move it around towards your side. movement and slide down your fingertips. Keep that going. Push your palm up toward the ceiling, extend your elbow, and down. So now your thumb is on the ring finger knuckle, okay? And your little finger is on the base of your own thumb and the crease of your wrist, okay? Once again, you relax your shoulders, draw it down towards your belly. And switch. And variations on this are you can take it from different sides, out further, but the basic is to draw it straight down, twisting as you go. Let's see. Your palms together, and you lock your fingers, stretch your knuckles, and rotate your wrists. Wrists go in circles. And shake. Breathe in. Settle it. Breathe out. Right where you're at, you can even spread it around. So, with 6Q, it's all stuff that'll help beginners. I started to do this many, many years ago, and then I didn't go through with it, so I'm glad it's come up recently. So, first thing we'll cover is bowing. And since you're in stage already, just have enough room around you and in front of you that you'll be able to bow. And when we're bowing to the kamiza, and you're sitting in seiza, both hands are relaxed here, not like this, and not like this. For us, it'll be one or two fists apart. Elbows are in, hands are relaxed. For bowing to the kamiza, we're formal bow, both hands come down, slide off to the knees, make a triangle, and you bow into that. My elbows would lightly touch my knees. Right? So this is also a cushion in case your head got pushed down. You know, your nose will go into the triangle that you create. Okay? And again, you've got big nose, you know. So one hand at a time is going to be gone over in a minute, right? But both hands at the same time. Okay? And then they both come back again. Okay? So try that for a minute. This is formal bow. Slides off of your knees and back onto your knees. Yep. Yep. And just catch yourself if you do this. Then when you're going to bow to the instructor and then to you, bow to your partners, you can do left hand first, right hand, and right hand returns, left hand. My understanding is it comes from the sword. If you're used to holding the sword, you hold onto the sword and bow with one hand. And by bringing the left hand forward first, it shows that you don't have a weapon. Any bowing should be sincere, not just mindless. You should have some presence, of what you're actually doing. If you come on the mat, give a standing bow, not to do something like that and move on to the mat. So let's stand up. We'll do a standing bow. So say you came to the edge of the mat, like anybody who's late coming into class today, you come to the edge of the mat and you wait. When the instructor sees you, they'll give a nod or a bow, and you would give a sincere bow of thanks for being allowed to come onto the mat. Then you would step onto the mat. You would give either a standing polite bow to the kamiza or go down into seiza for a sitting bow, okay? So, when you're bound not to let this go, it can still slide along your legs and you bend from the waist, not to purposely expose your neck. Okay? Try a few.